Hello and welcome to the learning video on flipped classroom implementation. Today we are going to discuss the out of class activity under flipped classroom. I am Dr. Payal Dande from SVKM's NMMS School of Pharmacy and Technology Management, Shirpur campus. Let us see the learning objective. After watching this video, you should be able to understand what do we mean by the out of class activity under flipped classroom. Similarly, we should also know what needs to be done by a teacher as well as by the students in out-of-class activity. Now, before going to the topic, let us first recall what we said earlier. That is, what do we mean by flipped classroom? Flipped classroom is an active learning strategy that uses technological knowledge to build the content in a pedagogical sequence to facilitate learning at all levels of Bloom's taxonomy. So basically, it helps students not only to understand and use the knowledge, but further to analyze it, evaluate, create, and use it in the practical application. So these were the two different parts of flipped classroom, which we have discussed earlier. So there are two parts. One is in class and the other is out class. So today we are going to talk about what needs to be done in the out of class. So out of class activity are divided into two parts, meaning the teacher and the student has to do some activities before the class and there are some activities which needs to be conducted after the class. So we'll be discussing about both in our slides to come. So let us first see what is to be done by a teacher as an out of class activity. So the teacher is expected to prepare and distribute lecture content to students. Now, this lecture content could be in various forms. It could be handouts of lecture. It could be prepared learning audiovisual videos of lecture by the teacher itself. Or the teacher can use learning videos from free learning sites and distribute for learning. Now, over here, one needs to remember that these learning videos should have Creative Commons license. Later, the teacher has to ask the students to watch it attentively before coming to the class. The teacher should also ask the students to write their queries, questions, and bring it to the class. There has to be some small assignments in the learning videos, whether you select it from the website or you make it of your own. You should be able to give some small assignments which are based on the same concept to confirm the understanding of the topic in the students. Besides this, it will also let you know as a teacher if the students have gone through the concept. Now, let us understand what is to be done by the students in the out-of-class activity. So, the students have to become active learners. They have to watch the learning videos or handouts, whichever is given by the teacher in the form of content knowledge. And it has to be done attentively. And this all needs to be done before coming to the class. This is very, very important. Before coming to the class. And then understand the concept. Write the queries or questions if there are any and bring it to the class. They also have to complete small assignments that are given in learning reference material based on the same concept and submit it before coming to the class. So this will reconfirm that the students have understood the concept. Now, to understand further the requirements of out-of-class activities which needs to be done by teacher and the students, you will see that there are three important aspects which are connected to each other. First, related to content. Second, related to the teaching practice or teaching methodology. And third, related to the technology that should be used. So how will we decide which technology or pedagogy will be used so that it can make our teaching learning process more effective? So now let us see how these three are correlated. First, you will find that the content will decide which teaching method will you use under the pedagogy. Similarly, it's the content and the pedagogy which will decide which technology will you use to explain that content effectively. So all the three are correlated to each other to make the TPAC model. And this is very important when you make the out-of-class activities for flipped classroom. So now take a pause and think as a teacher what you should know with respect to content, pedagogy, and technology to create the out-of-class activity for flipped classroom. You get 5 minutes to think and enlist your requirements. Hope you have done this. Now, to know about the answer, that is to know about the content, pedagogical and technological requirement, watch our learning video 3.2 on TPAC for out-of-class activity under flipped classroom. Thank you. Happy learning.